Hello everyone, so let's get started with the next module, that is module 4, Corona. So you have two topics in module 4, that is Corona and underground cables. So today's session, let's get started with Corona. So the learning objectives of this particular session are, so initially we will start with the phenomenon of Corona. So how would Corona takes place in transmission line? What are the factors that will affect Corona? And which are the various methods that are usually employed to reduce Corona? So, and later on, we will also derive certain expressions for disruptive voltage and visual critical voltage, and how this is, because of this voltage, Corona will occur. Okay, the reference value of 25 kV volts or 30 kilo volts. So we will get to know its impact on the effect of Corona. So what is this phenomenon of Corona? So Corona is mainly because of the ionization of air. So what is ionization? So an atom or a molecule will acquire a negative or positive charge by gaining or losing an electron to form ions. Okay, so the ionization is a process wherein a molecule will either takes an electron or loses an electron in order to form ions. And the main reason for ionization is because of the cosmic rays, UV radiations and radioactivity. So let's see a video on Corona and we'll just come back.
High voltage electrical transmission. It can be seen in transmission line,
actually,
which generally carry high voltage around 30 kV or
above. So Corona looks like in transmission line,
spread across the line conductor and also
ionization.
Now let's see about mechanism of Corona. When an alternating current is made to flow across two conductor of transmission line, whose spacing is large compared to.
Okay, so this is how Corona looks like. This is a reference to the video. So what is it? You found a sparkling on the line, that is because of the ionization, and you also saw an additional colored line which was just below a transmission line. So this is how Corona looks like, and it will also be a hissing sound, noise when Corona occurs. We will see exactly how is this Corona that is taking place. Okay, just you should consider a normal condition, and you will have two conductors and air is the medium between the two conductors, and you will have ionization of particles over there. When you apply a voltage between the two conductors, let's assume that you are applying an voltage between the two conductors and the spacing is large as compared to the diameters. And as already mentioned, air is the medium between the conductors, and this is subjected to dielectric stress. Okay, so dielectric stress, in the sense you are applying certain amount of potential difference. If this potential difference is less, there will not be any electrons that will coming out. They will not come out of the conductors. Okay, but if you give a more voltage, if you increase the voltage about 25 kV, stress will increase, and if you still increase it about 30 kilovolts, which is nothing but that, which is called as critical disruptive voltage, the field strength over there will obviously increase. So this field strength will make an electron that is present inside the conductor to come out. It oozes out. Electron will ooze out, and since air is the surrounding medium, it gets ionized. Okay, and its surrounding medium also starts getting conducting. The air also becomes conducting because of the stress. You have more electrons coming out of the conductors. When electrons come out of the conductor, when they start flowing through the air, air also becomes conducting, and that is called as Corona. Because of that, you get a hissing noise, or you will get some color or a sparkling that you saw in the video. Okay, and that phenomenon is called as Corona. This is because the electrons acquire velocity under the influence of potential gradient. It is subjected to stress. Stress over here is nothing but more potential difference. At critical disruptive voltages, the voltage acquired by these free electrons is capable to strike neutral molecule. And this, as I already explained, this force, whatever, because since you are increasing the voltage, the stress is more, and because of this force, more electrons will ooze out or dislodge. One or more electrons get dislodged from out, and it comes out. Okay, it oozes out of the conductor, and it will be flowing in the surrounding media, and the surrounding media is also air. So obviously, collision takes place, producing ions. And because of this, that is the reason they say corona is mainly because of the process of ionization. It's a phenomenon of ionization. Okay, and as I already mentioned, because of this making the conducting air, surrounding air also conducting, as electrons ooze out, comes out because of the more dielectric stress, or the potential gradient, as the potential gradient starts increasing, you will have an electric discharge, which is called as corona. Okay, so this is nothing but a faint luminescent glow color, and which will also be accompanied by a hissing sound. Okay, and this phenomenon is called as corona. And the consequence of corona, how would corona affect the line? It will cause corona power loss, and there will also be radio interference. So if you increase the stress much more, higher the voltage, you will have more envelope of color, that is, you can see more corona, the discharge will be more. So you will have a more larger luminous envelope. Okay, the envelope becomes larger. Whatever the sparkling that we saw and the line that we saw, that becomes larger and with more sound, and it will accompany by more power loss and radio interference. Okay, and this would also affect the insulation of the line. This loss, power loss, or this discharge will also affect the insulation of the line. And if the conductors are polished and smooth, you can have uniformity in the corona glow throughout the length of the conductors. Or if the conductors are not polished, okay, if they are concentrated, or if there are any rough points between in the conductors, so at the rough points, corona will be more. It looks more brighter. So if it's polished and smooth, it will be same throughout. If it's not polished and smooth, it will be brighter at certain points where the points are rough or crooked. So this is the corona glow. So if the lines are polished, it will be same throughout. Or if it is not polished, it will get concentrated at the certain points. What are the factors now? Let's see what are the factors that affect corona. Before that, I'll just brief what is corona. If the stress is more, if the voltage is less, you cannot experience corona. If the voltage is more, that is called as critical disruptive voltage, that is voltage above 30 kV, stress will increase. Once the stress starts increasing in the line, obviously electrons tries to come out. Since air is the surrounding medium, air gets ionized because of the flow of this electrons, because of the force, electrons get dislodged or they ooze out from the line, the conductor, and making the surrounding medium conducting, and that gives rise to corona discharge. One main important factor is atmospheric conditions, because ionization of air around the conductor is mainly the atmospheric condition, and that obviously will affect the corona. So voltage gradient for dielectric breakdown of air is directly proportional to density of air. So during the stormy day, number of ions present in the surrounding medium will be far. Stormy days, if the weather is wet, obviously ions present will be very much more when compared to the normal weather. So occurrence of corona will be more on such day than when you have clear weather. If you have fog or smog, okay, during that time, you will have more corona because of the weather conditions will directly affect. And if the weather is clear, effect of corona will obviously be less. And if the weather is not that clear, if it's stormy, even at lower voltage you can expect corona, not exactly at 30 kV, but even at lower voltage you can expect corona. The temperature will obviously affect, pressure will obviously affect, as we have already seen, raindrops, snow, fog, hoar frost and condensation. So all this will have, and also one important surface irregularities in the line. Okay, if there are any rough particles on the line, rough surfaces in the line, that will also increase the corona. Okay, so whenever you try to prevent corona or reduce corona, all these factors has to be taken into consideration. Next one is surface of the conductor. As already mentioned, if it is polished and smooth, effect will be less. If it's rough, effect will be more. The same point, we will just discuss it again. The presence of dirt or roughness of the conductor reduces the critical breakdown voltage, making the conductors more exposed to corona loss. And where in cities where you have high pollution and if the conductor surfaces are not that smooth, effect of corona obviously will increase. So if our intention is to reduce the effect of corona, we should also consider the surface of the conductor into consideration. Size of the conductor. Corona is inversely proportional to the diameter of the conductors. So effect of corona reduces with the increase in size of the conductor. Why do you say that the effect of corona reduces with the increase in the size of the conductor? Because the process of ionization, because it prevents the electrons, much of the electrons coming out. Because only if the electrons get dislodged because of the force, and if they come out, you will have, it makes the surrounding air conductive. So that you can prevent to some extent by increasing the size of the conductor. Spacing between the conductor. Whenever you have two or more conductors, and you can think of larger spacing reduces the electrostatic stress on the surface of the conductor. Because of this dielectric stress or force, because of the higher voltage force, electrons get dislodged. So if you provide enough spacing between the conductors, you can somehow prevent the stress that is happening because of the higher voltages, and thereby reduce the effect of corona. Line voltage, as I already mentioned, if it's about 25 kV, stress will increase, and if you still increase it to 30 kV, electrons get dislodged, leading to corona. So line voltage will also play an important parameter, or it's important factor, because this line voltages will increase the stress. At low voltages, stress will obviously be less. Since that stress is less, it's not that efficient, it's not sufficient. Stress is not sufficient to ionize the nearby particles. So no discharge. So if as the voltage starts increasing, more stress, electrons get dislodged much, leading to discharge. So what are the advantages of corona? So the effective diameter of the conductor increases since the air around the conductor becomes surrounding. This reduces the electrostatic stress between the conductors. So if you just increase the diameter, our intention is you can reduce the stress. Thereby, you cannot make the surrounding air conducting, preventing corona. The probability of flashover is also reduced. You just saw corona descent like a flashover in the video that I showed. This flashover will also be reduced, and this corona discharge will also affect the insulators. Insulators will also get affected because of this discharge. Effect reduces the surges produced by transients such as lighting. That will also get reduced. So disadvantages: corrosion because of the discharge. The noise will be audible, it causes audible noise. One more is, as I already mentioned, it will cause radio interferences and power loss. So these are some of the disadvantages, major disadvantages of corona, or effects of corona. And there are certain cases wherein current drawn by the line due to corona will not be sinusoidal. So if the current drawn by the line, if it's not completely sinusoidal, so it would cause power quality problems in the equipment that are connected to the line. So this is also one of the major problem. Corona will also damage polymeric insulators. As I said, most of the insulators are made up of polymers. or yeah. So when this corona discharge would also affect the material, for whatever the materials that are used, you know, to manufacture the insulators, that materials will also get deteriorated. Okay, the lifespan would get reduced. This is also one of the major effects of corona. The next one is critical disruptive wood, which are all this. Our second objective of today's session was to derive an expression for critical disruptive voltage. What is this critical disruptive voltage? So this critical disruptive voltage is the voltage at which corona occurs. Rather, to derive and all that, we should know what exactly it is. At this threshold itself, corona takes place, that is 30 kV, whatever that we saw. Okay, that's voltage above a particular threshold to cause corona, as already mentioned. It's defined as the minimum phase neutral voltage at which corona occurs. So you have 25, you don't have corona. You have 10 kV, you don't have corona. But exactly at 30 kV, you have corona. That's the minimum phase neutral voltage at which corona occurs. So let's, because we have to consider two conductors, because between the two only, you will have corona. So we will be considering two conductors of radii r centimeters, and they are spaced at a distance of d centimeters apart. Consider Vp as phase neutral potential, and then the potential gradient. G is nothing but the potential gradient at which the surface of the conductor. G is nothing but the potential gradient at the surface of the conductor is nothing but Vp is nothing but phase to neutral voltage divided by R ln D divided by R volt per centimeter. Okay. The potential gradient G must be sufficient for the air to break down to cause the. This value of G is very important. It's Vp, phase to neutral voltage divided by R ln D by R. So this should contribute, this gradient is contributing for the cause of corona. Okay, the breakdown strength of air at a pressure is of 76 centimeter of mercury and a temperature of 25 degrees Celsius. So it's approximately of 30 kV per centimeter. Okay, so you will get an RMS value of that as 21.2 kV per centimeter, and you can denote it as G. So let's move on to the next one after considering certain considerations. So you'll have to assume Vc as the critical phase to neutral potential, which is in kilovolts, and the expression for that is G naught Vc. Earlier it was Vp R ln D by R k kilovolt per volt per centimeter. So now we will replace that Vp as critical disruptive voltage Vc. Okay, this G naught is the RMS value of the potential gradient. So how do you simplify the expression? It's nothing but Vc is nothing but G naught R ln D by R. So once you substitute the value of G naught, which is in RMS, that is, it was G was in 30 kV, which was the maximum value. RMS value is termed as G naught, 21.2 R ln D by R kV per phase, which is in RMS. The value of this particular critical disruptive voltage is 21 point whatever. It's considered for a condition of 76 centimeter pressure and at a temperature, a normal temperature of 25 degrees Celsius, and the type of conductor that is considered over here is smooth, not rough. Okay. Under these conditions, you are getting an expression of Vc as 21.2 ln D by R, 21.2 R ln D by R kV per phase, and this voltage is at a condition of at a pressure of 76 centimeter and a temperature of 25 degrees Celsius, and the conductor type of is a smooth conductor, there are no rough surfaces. And this expression will automatically change if you consider a rough conductor, or if the atmospheric condition changes, or if the surface of the condition changes, so it's get affected. So atmospheric condition in the sense, if the temperature increases, if the pressure increases, and if the surface changes, above expression will change. And 21.2 R ln D by R is for a certain conditions, 76 centimeter pressure and 25 degree Celsius temperature, and for a smooth conductor. If you change that, obviously Vc will also change. The dielectric strength of air may not always be equal to 30 kilovolt per centimeter. So in that case, how do you find out? So it's nothing but Vc G delta M naught R ln D by R kilovolt per phase, because this Vc is dependent on the type of conductor. air density. Okay. As a result, all these parameters would affect critical disruptive voltage, because critical disruptive voltage is the voltage at which corona occurs. Okay, so when you have to see a voltage, at what voltage corona is happening or it is occurring, you should consider the air surrounding air density factor. You should also know the conductor spacing D. You should also know the radius of the conductor. You should also know the dielectric strength of it. As a result, Vc is nothing but G delta M naught R ln T by R kV per phase RMS. What is this M naught? This is a value that denotes, you should consider certain values. If it is smooth, you are supposed to take a value of M naught towards a particular value. So if it is rough, another value. Okay, delta is nothing but air density. How do you calculate it? It's 3.92 b divided by 273 plus b. Barometric pressure in centimeter, it would be given. That should also be considered in order to know the air density factor, because air density factor is directly proportional to critical disruptive voltage. Okay, M naught accounts, what is this M naught? It's nothing but irregularity factor of the conductor surface. So if it's smooth and polished, you can consider it as 1. If it's a dirty conductor with all of dust on it, it's 0.98 to 0.92. And if it's a stranded conductor, it's not solid. There's a difference between solid and stranded, which I've told you in your previous sessions. So it's 0.87 to 0.8. Okay, all these factors has to be considered, because all these factors are directly proportional to Vc, which is nothing but critical disruptive voltage. And all these factors will have significant effect of Vc, and Vc will also tell you what would be the, will there be a corona discharge or not. Next is visual critical voltage. What is this visual? The two voltages in this chapter you are supposed to know as critical disruptive voltage and visual critical voltage. Before knowing the derivation, let's know what exactly it is. Critical disruptive voltage is the voltage at which corona occurs. Visual critical voltage is the voltage at which you can see corona glow. A critical disruptive voltage is only telling at this voltage corona is occurring, but visual voltage is sitting at this particular voltage, you can, all corona has occurred and you are able to see the glow or the discharge. You can see, not at critical disruptive voltage, you can see the discharge or the corona glow at visual critical voltage. There is some difference of voltages between critical disruptive voltages and visual critical voltage. Corona glow will not occur at critical disruptive voltage. Because corona, it starts when the stress increases, electrons start getting dislodged and surrounding area becomes conducting, and that is critical disruptive. After some time, you will have visual critical voltage, and that is called as minimum phase to neutral voltage at which corona glow appears. Critical disruptive voltage is minimum phase to neutral voltage at which corona occurs. This is minimum phase to neutral voltage at which corona glow appears. And this expression, there is no derivation for it. You can just remember the equation. It's Vv is equal to Mv delta R 1 plus 0.3 divided by root of delta R ln T by R kV per phase. And again, Mv is nothing but the irregularity factor. And its value is 1 if the conductors are smooth and polished. If it's rough, its value is 0.72 to 0.82. Okay, so visual is the critical voltage, the voltage at which we can see or we can see corona. The one important expression for, so all these expressions are important in order to solve the problems, which we can discuss in the next session. So power loss due to corona. So corona is usually accompanied by the loss of energy. Okay, power, like energy get lost because of the discharge, energy get lost, and it will be dissipated in the form of light. As I showed you the glow, there was light there. There is also heat, because whenever there is power loss, there will be heat. I also mentioned there is sound. Okay, there will be a hissing sound. And we also spoke about chemical reaction, not directly, because I also mentioned that corona discharge would affect polymeric insulators. The materials will get affected. Quality of the materials get deteriorated because there will be some chemical reaction. The discharge, when it starts flowing through the polymeric insulators, they get reacted, and their efficacy would reduce, or their material capability would reduce. So these are some of the effects of corona. That is, you will be able to witness it, see it in the form of light, heat, you can hear it in the form of sound, and it will also, it is also accompanied by chemical reaction. So the peaks formula for power loss due to corona is, this is the expression, 242.2 into F plus 25 by delta root of R by G, V minus VC square into 10 power minus 5 kilowatt per kilometer per phase. So this is the expression for power loss due to corona. There is no derivation. All expressions has to be remembered in order to solve the problems. And your frequency, you can also see one more factor. Frequency will directly affect corona power loss. So in DC, there is no frequency, no corona loss, or less. The loss will be less. You cannot say no loss because it's F plus 25. If it is DC, it will be 0 plus 25. Corona loss, power loss will be less. So if it is AC, corona loss will be more because it deals with frequency. F is the supply frequency, delta is the air density factor. Normally it will be given in the problems. It's 5.5. V is phase to neutral voltage, and VC is critical disruptive voltage. So which are the various methods to reduce? How do we reduce corona? It's again the factors. You have to just remember the factors and start thinking of reducing the corona. One is increasing the size of the conductor. What will happen when you increase the size of the conductor? Critical disruptive voltage will, you can increase it. And because size, when you increase, voltage capability will increase, stress will be reduced. So it prevents the electrons getting dislodged. Okay, this will reduce the effect of corona. As that is the reason they say ACSR conductors, aluminium conductor, steel reinforced, will have larger radius, and they can reduce, not prevent or eliminate, they can reduce the effect conductor when compared to other stranded or solid conductors. Okay, ACSR conductors will have larger radius. When you have larger radius, conductors can withstand more stress. Okay, and they will also prevent the dislodging of electrons. The force will be less. And the same expression that we saw, so this expression will tell you that corona will be, R is there, R is proportional to P. Obviously, if you think of reducing, if you think for increasing the value of R, you can obviously try to mitigate. So next is conductor spacing, the D value. Whenever you have two between conductors, you will have dielectric. That's D, the distance between the two conductors. This is very, very important. Okay. So as you start increasing the spacing of the conductor, critical voltage will obviously increase. So when you do it, what will happen? You can, as I already mentioned, you can reduce the stress, you will have more capacity to withstand. Obviously, corona can be reduced. The major problem over here is it would increase the maintenance cost, or economics pertaining to this would increase, because you need to invest more on supporting structures like supports and towers in order to ensure that. So that will also be a disadvantage in terms of economics, but yet that is one of the method to reduce corona. And bundle conductors are usually preferred for higher voltages because they have, we can transfer more power, as already mentioned in the previous session. So bundle conductors are again more, you will have more stranded conductors in that. So because of that stranded, it will have more increase in the effective radius. Once you increase the effective radius, will have its capacity will be more. It can withstand good voltage, higher voltages. As a result, the frequency or the rate at which electrons used to get dislodged in the previous cases, over here it will reduce, and obviously corona can also be reduced. Corona rings Okay, corona rings is the equipment that is used to reduce the corona. So electric field is greater where conductor curvature is sharp. That is the reason they say that conductors has to be smooth. If it is sharp or it's not even, uneven shapes, usually we'll have more electric field over there. So as a result, we'll have more corona discharge at the sharp points, such as edges and corners. To prevent this, what is that equipment that is usually employed? To prevent this, corona rings are employed at the terminals of a very high voltage equipment. Corona rings are incorporated or they are employed at the terminals. So because at the terminals, you will have more corona discharge. So they are installed at terminals of very high voltage equipment. So this corona ring is electrically connected to high voltage conductors. Where usually, as I said, corona discharge will be more at the sharp points. So rings will also be installed at that particular points. So this will obviously reduce the potential gradient. In other words, be very simple. As soon as you employ a corona ring, that will reduce the stress or the potential gradient at the surface of the conductor. And as a result, it distributes or balances the stress across the area of the conductor. Thereby, if the stress is reduced, obviously the corona effect will also get reduced. And where are these rings employed? Usually they are employed at the top and bottom of the string insulators of high voltage transmission line. Corona rings are employed at the top and bottom of the string insulators. You know, string insulators are made up of porcelain. That is the reason the corona discharge will also affect polymeric insulators, because they are made up of porcelain. Once the discharge occurs, porcelain material will also get damaged. So life cycle will also get reduced. So this is the diagram, and I've mentioned the source. So this is the diagram wherein corona rings are employed in order to add the sharp ends, because you'll have more discharge over there. So once you install a corona ring, it will reduce the potential gradient or the stress, obviously reducing the effect of corona on the line. Next one is surface treatment. So you should always ensure that the surface is always smooth, polished. Okay. So because this would, if it's sharp or if it's blunt at certain places, that would increase the stress or more electric field over that area. So that would obviously increase the critical disruptive voltage or cause corona discharge at that particular point. As a result, surface treatment has to be employed. That is, it has to be able to ensure that the surface is smooth and there are very less number of rough surfaces, or there are no rough surfaces. And homogeneous insulators reduces chances of arcing due to corona, because sometimes because of the insulator itself, you can see a flashover once the corona starts discharging. Because of the type of insulator material that would react, because of that chemical reaction, sometimes you might also see arcing or fire because of that chemical reaction. So if you use homogeneous insulators, you can reduce such chances of arcing or flashover. That usually gets created because of the chemical reaction between the corona discharge and the insulator. Sharp bends is already mentioned, because sharp bends or edges will increase the stress on the conductor. So this should totally be avoided, because where there is more stress, obviously we'll have more discharge at that particular points. So this should also be kept in mind in order to, if at all there is absolute necessary of reducing the effect of corona, these are some of the important factors that has to be taken into consideration in mitigating the effect of corona. Thank you.